Everything is useful. Everything in nature is linked together from the primitive Adam to the archangel, who also began as only an Adam, an admirable law of harmony.
As much as the human mind asks questions about life in conjuncture of today's undeniably vast intellectual knowledge, it is still difficult to find adequate answers that enable it to grasp life's full meaning and significance. What is life? Biologists state that life is the result of cells organized in remarkable agglutinations, forming individualized organs, systems, and functions. Philosophers offer various formulations that derive from their experiential and cultural perspective, in accordance with the school to which they belong. However, they restrict life to the period between the cradle and the grave.
And thus, successively, people understand and define life in accordance with their own perception, emotion, and cultural capacity, furnishing concepts that are compatible with their own way of being. Yet, the miracle of life is much more complex, and for that very reason, its point of origin can only be found in the Creator, who engendered it and who has been guiding it across billions of years, affecting indispensable adaptations, developments, and variations in its structure.
Alan Kardec, through a rational study of facts, realized in the 1800s there was much more that could give way to understanding certain universal laws regarding life that would unveil to human beings an entire new horizon.
From his findings, one can state that everything in nature is a miracle because everything is wonderful and bears witness to divine wisdom.
Life is seen as a gift. Immortality of the soul is presented, offering a new view about life.
In the beginning, ignorant about its destiny, the immortal spirit awakens to its own reality by means of intellectual and moral experiences that enable it to achieve plenitude. Physical existence is an opportunity for enchantment and accomplishment by which the immortal spirit beautifies itself and reaches the heights of reality.
Reincarnation. Like the humble yet noble seed, which due to its death will never behold the golden ear that emerged from it, the spirit, in its initial simplicity as a psyche, cannot perceive the pure spirit that lies silent in its inner being, and which one day will sail the infinite rivers of immortality. As the spirit matures, psychologically, the joy of living is a powerful reason to pursue enlightenment. Such joy, of course, does not impede moments of pain-induced reflection, of yearning for love, of longing for health, of the presence of infirmity, of temporary anguish, or of anxiety about certain factors. Whether incarnate or discarnate, we all walk a wide field of experiences and trials that are in harmony with the imperatives of the growth toward immortality. Through enlightenment and growth and understanding of life, the desire one has of ending one's own life gives way to understanding that this is all temporary, that their destinies is the same for all, happiness.
Self-knowledge reveals to them their potential and limitations, opening up room for renewal, for wishing to start again. It puts an end to materialistic and pessimistic ideas that sees life as a mere means of suffering, often leading thousands to the idea of suicide, euthanasia, and abortion as an escape mechanism for dealing with distressing situations.
Since the release of the Spirit's book 160 years ago, Spiritism has been summoning human beings to understand life, to respect God, the creator of all things, themselves, each other, and all living and non-living expressions that comprise their environment, in order to learn and be happy, thus acquiring plenitude. As we grow, as we evolve, as we understand the mechanics of life and its meaning, we inevitably come face to face with the greatest universal law, ruling all of creation, the law of love and justice.
History's greatest psychotherapist, Jesus, proposed the meanings for acquiring peace. Love God above all things and one's neighbor as oneself. It will be through the